Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel. In this video, I would like to explain Taylor series expansion of a function in two variables. Already you know that a function in two variables is represented by f of x comma y. See, suppose f of x comma y is a continuous differentiable function at the point a comma b, then the Taylor series expansion about the point a comma b is f of x comma y is equal to very first term in the expansion is f of a comma b, nothing but functioning value at the point a comma b, plus 1 by 1 factorial whole into x minus a into f suffix x at a comma b. Here f suffix x is nothing but partial differentiation of f with respect to x at the point a comma b, plus y minus b into partial differentiation of f with respect to y at the point a comma b, plus 1 by 2 factorial into x minus a whole square into f double x at a comma b. F suffix double x is nothing but second order partial differentiation of f with respect to x, nothing but dou square f by dou x square, okay, plus 2 times of x minus a into y minus b into fxy at a comma b, partial differentiation of f with respect to y and x, plus y minus b whole square into f double y at a comma b, plus 1 by 3 factorial into, already you should observe that this term is in the form of a minus b whole square, a plus b whole square, that's why this term should be in the form of a plus b whole cube. So you will get x minus a whole cube f triple x at a comma b, plus 3 into x minus a whole square into y minus b into fxy f double x at y at the point a comma b, plus 3 times of x minus a into y minus b whole square into f suffix double y at a comma b. These are all partial differentiations. This is third order partial differentiation. Plus last term is y minus b whole cube into f triple y at the point a comma b, close the bracket, plus so on. This is called Taylor series expansion of f of x comma y in the neighborhood of the point a comma b. Okay, this is also known as power series expansion of f of x comma y in the positive powers of the term x minus a and y minus b. Clearly we are observing that this expansion gives expansion of f of x comma y in the positive powers of the terms x minus a and y minus b. Okay, that's why this is also known as power series of f of x comma y in the positive powers of the term x minus a and y minus b. Okay, suppose if in this formula the point a comma b becomes origin, then Taylor series becomes Maclaurin's. So that is Maclaurin series of f of x comma y becomes f of 0 comma 0. Just replace a is equal to 0, b is equal to 0. Whenever we have a and whenever we have b, blindly replace them by 0. So you will get Maclaurin series expansions. Okay. So 1 by 1 factorial into x minus 0. It would be x into fx at origin plus plus y into f suffix y at origin plus 1 by 2 factorial into x square into f double x at origin plus 2xy into fxy at origin plus y square into f double y at origin. Second order partial differentiation of f with respect to y. Close the bracket. And we have to write another term also. 1 by 3 factorial into x cube into f triple x at origin plus 3x square y f double x at f double x y at origin plus 3x y square fx double y at origin plus y cube f triple y. Third order partial differentiation of f with respect to y at origin plus so on. Okay, so clearly we are observing that Maclaurin series expansion gives expansion of f of x comma y in terms of x and y, but Taylor's gives the expansion of f of x comma y in the terms of x minus a and y minus b. That is the difference between Taylor's and Maclaurin's. These Taylor's and Maclaurin's are also known as generalized mean value theorems. Okay, generalized mean value theorems. In the next video, I will give the problems on both Taylor's and Maclaurin's. Thank you very much.